Today I'm going to be sharing my experience of Yupo paper, specifically transparent Yupo paper. Now, I had never heard of this paper until a very nice lady actually gave it to me for my birthday. Yeah, thank you. If you're watching this, thank you for that. But in order to justify this gift, I really wanted to do the biggest, most elaborate piece I've done. So to start this off, what I ended up doing is I ended up taking a sheet of this paper and used it as a testing sheet. And I recommend this anytime you are trying a new type of paper, have a test sheet where you just go crazy trying every little idea you have as to how to use the mediums you like on this paper. This will give you such a better foundation for actually getting into the project. You'll know a lot more what to expect. However, with this, I did all of these tests and I lost the footage, so I can't show you the footage of that. Which I'm so sad. I came up with the conclusion that I thought graphite would work the best on this paper. It did pretty well covering a large area. You could still get fine details, but really good coverage. As far as erasing, I could erase most of this really well, which gave me the idea maybe I could work dark to light instead of light to dark with this. Once I came to this conclusion, I was so excited to tackle this project, so I settled on a snake. And it's at this point in the video where if you don't like snakes, you might not want to stick around. And I totally would understand. Just leave a comment down below. I am not a fan of snakes. But I like snakes. I'm kind of strange. I like snakes. So I really wanted to draw this for myself. I decided, well, why not see if I can cover all of this with a layer of graphite right off the bat. Because again, I was really excited to see if I could work from dark to light with this instead of from light to dark. At first I started by just covering the paper with my pencil, but man, that takes forever. So then I decided to see if I like diluted it with water, how would that work? You guys might be laughing at me right now. You don't dilute graphite with water. It doesn't really work. But it did spread it out just enough that I was able to let it dry and then go back on top of it with my soft tools and blend it out a little bit. And this did help a little. I don't know that I'll ever try that again though. Then I jumped right into the eyes. I wanted to see just how dark could I get this right at the start. And it fit the bill for what I was trying to do with this project. If you guys do like snakes and want to see the final result of this, feel free to stick to the end because you guys, I am so excited with how this turned out. It was totally worth the 365 days I spent on this. Not all in one sitting because I'm not that patient, but I spent a ton of time on this and it was all worth it. So I started the same place I do with everything. I sketched out my drawing, made sure all of the proportions were exactly where I wanted them to be, because with all of this detail and the size of this, I knew it was gonna take me forever. So by doing that, I didn't want to start off on the wrong foot and have my proportions way off, because no matter how much detail and time I pour into this, if the proportions aren't right, the whole drawing will look so wrong. I can't stress that enough. So I spent the extra time to make sure this was perfect. Then I took it and I transferred it onto this paper because I wasn't sure how well sketching would work on this paper. I didn't want to mess it up before I even got started. So I transferred it. I love my deepest of values, my darks, to be so deep. And I didn't feel like I could do that with this paper. I tried, I really, really did, but I didn't feel like it quite got there. And at the same time, I was fighting with the shine because the more I layered this and tried to get it darker, the shinier the graphite was. As far as actually lifting up all the details though and working from dark to light, this is where I have absolutely fallen in love with this paper. If I ever want to work from dark to light with graphite again, I am using this paper. Hands down, I am using this paper because you guys, it was so easy. I literally just covered a section in graphite and then used my eraser, used my kneaded eraser, and lifted up all of those details. You guys, how much longer would this have taken me if I had to actually draw in all of those little details? Guys, we're talking 3, 4, 5 years. I mean, I'm kidding, but it would have taken me forever. So as I'm going through this project, it didn't take me long to figure out where the strengths and weaknesses were in this paper. Clearly, I couldn't get very deep with my darkest shadows, which was a disappointment. I really want to figure out how to get darker values in this, get those darks really rich, really deep, and honestly, that's the biggest weakness to this paper, is just you can't get it that dark without contrasting that with so much graphite shine. If I can figure out a way to get it darker without the shine, I think that would have made this the perfect paper I've ever used for graphite. It was such a blast to draw on. As far as working from dark to light, this was amazing and so easy. Yes, I picked the most detailed and the largest piece I could possibly do on this paper, but when you really think about it, all this detail didn't take me that long. If I had done this on like hot pressed watercolor paper, it would have taken me so much longer than it took me to do it on this paper. I highly, 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 highly recommend this paper for using with graphite. And if you'd like to see other tutorials I've done with graphite, then check this video out and also other time lapses down here. Thank you for watching. Until next time, God bless.